Welcome back. It's Thirsty Thursday edition. It's the last call. This is usually where Frank corrects all my mistakes, but we made a big mistake earlier. We didn't get to Melissa Chen, but she's finally here, thankfully. You may remember she was here last week. She stood behind her editor, Freddie Gray's thought that this was a rinky-dink studio.
Actually, and, looks much better today.
It looks better already, doesn't it? Yeah. Melissa Chen joins us. She's the New York City editor for Spectator USA. And Melissa, since you've been appointed just a couple weeks ago, so much is going on in the city and around the world. I want to get your thoughts on the impeachment. My thoughts were, yesterday they rolled out their first two superstars. You always lead off with your best, right?
Yep.
You either lead off with them or you close with them. Me, I decided to close today's show with you.
Okay.
But they led off with these two yesterday, Ambassador Taylor and this other guy, Kent, who wore a bow tie. I thought it was a complete dud. What did you think?
I thought so, too. In fact, I think if you stepped outside the Twitter bubble into real life, not many people were really caring about the impeachment. Like, if you just turned off the TV, turn off your life, you know, newsfeed, no one was really talking about it. And it was one of those things where you go online and it's the only thing trending and all the news outlets are just putting things out. But in the real world, I think people are kind of sick of this disaster porn, you know? We've had incident after incident in terms of trying to take Trump down. Avenatti and Stormy Gates, Russia Gates, and people are kind of tired of this constant turmoil.
So you're at the Spectator USA. You guys take a kind of slightly humorous look, but a serious news look at politics. You come at it from the conservative side. And I really appreciate you coming in and giving us a little time. Freddie was here, but now you're our regular.
Okay.
Hopefully. I thought it was quite curious that when the two superstar witnesses blow up yesterday, then this morning the lead story on all the left-wing channels is Deval Patrick enters the race. So they wanna blow some smoke and don't look over there at these guys who told us nothing. Deval Patrick is coming in.
Right.
Is this a good thing for the Dems or?
Well, the field is so crowded, and Deval Patrick, it doesn't make sense. He's just, you know, he's a two-timed governor of Massachusetts. I don't really understand what he brings additionally to the race. What's interesting also what's happening is that Pete Buttigieg actually just leapfrogged over everybody else in the Iowa polls.
That's right.
Right?
Well, supposedly.
So, right.
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
Not that these polls actually mean anything.
No.
I want to ask you this. Do you think this is the reason that Barack Obama hasn't endorsed Joe Biden because he's waiting to bring his boy Deval Patrick in?
Maybe, possibly.
Maybe.
But also, I think Obama's been trying to distance himself from Biden.
I want you to take a look at Jim Jordan's comments from yesterday, and I want to get your thoughts on that. Here's Jim Jordan from yesterday's impeachment hearing.
The staff that gets to talk to that person. The rest of us don't. Only chairmanship knows who the whistleblower is. We don't. We will never get the chance. We will never get the chance to see the whistleblower raise his right hand, swear to tell the truth and nothing but the truth. We'll never get that chance. More importantly, the American people won't get that chance. This anonymous so-called whistleblower with no firsthand knowledge, who's biased against the president, who worked with Joe Biden, who is the reason we're all sitting here today, will never get a chance to question that individual.
Well, apparently Jim Jordan was wrong. Because right here at Liquid Lunch, Frank Morano came through, and joining Melissa Chen and I on set is the whistleblower for his second appearance. Thank you for joining us, Mr. Whistleblower. We're in the final minute of the show. I want to ask you a question. I don't know if Melissa has any questions, but I'm sure you were watching the impeachment hearings very closely yesterday. And give me one whistle for yes, two for no. Was this a total mockery in your view? It was not a mockery. It was a mockery. That was a double whistle when one was... Okay, good. Melissa, you want to ask the whistleblower? It's rare we get the whistleblower in here.
I do. Can you drink?
Yeah, let's see. Can you drink with the whistle in your mouth?
Yeah,
this will be a trick. Okay. All right, you got to love Melissa Chen. She's great. Mr. Whistleblower, will you join us again as we continue our coverage here? Thank you so much. Frank Morano comes through. Melissa Chen comes through for us also. And one of our fact checkers out there, Frank Barbarino, wanted me to remind our audience it took Deval Patrick three times to pass the bar. Tomorrow, Liquid Lunch, same bat time, same bat channel.